It is 4:20, April 20th. I'm at the pack out, eating a little snack. I've got some deer forelegs I was given by a friend of mine that hunts. Zulu eating hers. I know a lot of hunters, and I asked them to give me the parts of the carcasses they don't use, so all of them can get utilized. I give them to my dogs. Kurgan already ate a deer leg. I filmed another video of that, and he's currently munching on a fish. My Renaissance Bulldog Wrecker. Month-old Renaissance Bulldog Magi, Wrecker's sister. And my Lycan Shepherd Ulu, who turns two. Hey, sweetheart. She turns two here in 3 days, April 23rd. Telling me thank you for her meal. She does that all the time. That right there. What's left of the full deer leg that Kurgan ate. Again, I filmed a video of that. That'll probably already be on the channel by the time this one gets up. So these are more just kind of a chew snack. This isn't their meal today. And I'm giving it to them in a pack setting because I think it helps build a healthy pack dynamic. I've explained that in several of my videos. Kurgan with a little 420 sushi. Jay telling Kurgan that's her piece. Kurgan now going to the bathroom after eating. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna pause this while I clean up what Gergen did. Wrecker lost his leg. As I say in every video, I like to handle my dogs when they're eating. Again, it prevents things like food aggression. It's especially important when you have children. As a former animal warden, part of my job was to take bite reports and deal with biting dogs, and I've seen a lot of disfigured children over the years. So again, it's really good to get your dogs used to being handled by the human pack members. You know, it's not enough that they just tolerate it from the alpha of the household. They should tolerate it from everyone. Good girl. Slick. You're gonna lose your piece to Gergen if you don't stay with it. Yes, my Lycan Shepherd Ulu. She turns 2 in 3 days. No kisses right now. Again, that's all healthy pack behavior. Water bowls. Again, I like to use these pack feedings to build a healthy pack dynamic. Helps them maintain a social structure, and it also allows me to put them in situations where they might have a conflict, and I can step in and nip it in the bud and teach them the appropriate way to resolve it. And I have other videos showing that if you'd like to see that. This is that puppy that was very food aggressive in my videos, and you can see now he has absolutely no issues with it, and that's because of the way we addressed it when he was young. And of course we have the king, Mr. Kurgan. For those who will ask, where is Lobo? He's inside with my son. They were enjoying some food together, and he wanted to stay in with him. Never pretty watching a bulldog eat. Lots of saliva everywhere. eating the hoof off that. You can clearly see in these situations the bulldog jaw was designed for gripping and holding, and is at a disadvantage when it comes through powering through stuff like this compared to a more wolfy jaw. Mork. He looks like him, don't he? Well, I hope you enjoyed this video of their 420 deer snack. If you want to learn more about how to feed a raw diet, I've got plenty of links down below from vet resources that'll tell you the science behind it and how to implement it. Please look there first before asking me any questions. I'd like to welcome all the new subscribers to the channel and say thank you to those who've been there along the way. I appreciate you both. That's all. Oh, also, if you disagree with what I'm doing, that's okay. Do how you want to do with your dogs. This is just what I do with mine. See ya. Thank you.